Welcome to another learning lab. Today we are going to learn how to create a process book display. We are going to see the differences between the run mode and the build mode. We are going to build trends. We are going to go over the options of trends. We are going to add static elements to our display and learn how to enhance the display with live elements, such as the value of a PI tag, a progress bar, and a multi-state object. And we are also going to learn how to manipulate a trend display. So let's go to ProcessBook. I have ProcessBook 3.2 open. If we go to File and New, we can select a new ProcessBook display that I'm going to name ProcessBook Batch Reactor. Click OK and we can maximize our work area. If we go to Arrange, we can click on a Snap to Grid and it will give us a friendly work environment. Also, notice the difference between the run mode and the build mode. Right now we are in build mode, so we can create our process book display. To collect and display data, we want to switch to the run mode. If we go to Tools, Preferences, if the preferred run mode box is checked, that will cause ProcessBook to switch back to run mode every time we complete an action. So if you're having that problem, make sure that you come to this screen and uncheck the preferred run mode, which will allow you to stay in build mode until you finish your work. Now we are ready to add some elements to our display. I'm going to click on the symbol library and drag a rectangle. That will bring up the pop-up window where I can select my elements. And here I'm going to go to the tanks section and I'm going to select reactor number 4. In here you can click options to change the color of the fill mode if you want a solid tank, hollow, and so forth. I'm going to keep the default settings, but I'm going to resize my tank, make it look a little bit nicer. Okay, and I'm going also to add some pipes by clicking again on the symbol library. I want to create an outlet pipe. Let me see, short horizontal pipe will work. Click OK. And I'm going to create an inlet pipe. Let's click on the symbol library again and place it here. And going down to the pipe section, I'm going to select a short vertical pipe. Click OK. And I'm also going to add an isolation valve. So going down to the valve section, I like this one, the hand valve number 2. Click OK, reposition that valve, resize it so that it looks nice. And that's OK. Now I'm going to make sure that each one of these elements is in the right position by clicking on Arrange and bring it to front. That will place my tank in front of all of the drawings. So now that the tank is in front of the other objects, I'm going to add now some text, and I can click on the text icon and enter stir tank. And while the text is highlighted, I can change the font, the size of the font, and I'm going to make it bold, and I'm going to change the color of the font to black. So that looks nice. I want now to align the tank and the text, and by selecting both of them, by selecting both the tank and the text, I can go to arrange, align, and center both objects together. I am now ready to add some dynamic elements, and what I'm going to do is add a value of a tag right here to the left of my tank. By doing a tag search, I'm going to select the level 1, and I'm going to include the timestamp at the bottom of the value. I click OK. I can reposition my value, change the text, and I can also highlight all of this and move it together a bit to the right. Now let me include also some text here. I'm gonna say that this is the level percent for my tank. So I have a dynamic value now that represents the level in this tank, and I'm going to add some additional dynamic elements. I'm going to add a bar here in the tank that will indicate or will provide a visual indication of level inside the tank, and I'm also going to add a circle at the top and at the bottom indicating that my tank is either at the maximum or lowest level. So let's go ahead and add a circle at the top, and we can right click and copy that and place another one on the bottom, and these are going to be small indications of my upper and lower maximum level. Now by clicking first on the top circle, I can go ahead to my multi-state symbol. I'm going to select the same tag I selected before, level 1, and what I want to do with this multi-state is for it to provide an indication that if the tank is below 90% of the level, then the condition is green. Otherwise, the condition will be red, indicating a high level in the tank. I click OK, and I can do the same for the bottom indication, selecting level 1 as the tag, but in this case, if the level is below 10%, then the condition will be red. If the level is above the 10%, then it will be green. I click OK, and I can see an indication that right now the level is in between 10 and 90%. I want to have a better indication of level, so I can go ahead and add a bar, which is another dynamic element that will monitor also the values found in level 1, and I can click OK, and I can see now an indication of level inside the tank. I am now ready to add a graph to my ProcessBook display that will plot the level for me by searching for the level 1 tag and naming this plot batch reactor level, and selecting the auto range scale I'm going to start collecting data 8 hours ago until the current time. With a full time stamp, I click OK and I have my graph on the process book display. I can now click on the run mode and the graph now is live, and so is the bar and the indications for upper and lower maximum levels. I'm monitoring level in this tank with real-time data. I can at this point save my process book display as a PDI file, and by clicking save I can always go back and open that file, and it will open the same display with the elements monitoring my data real-time being displayed from the PI server. Some of the features that I have here in my graph, by clicking on it, or actually double clicking on the graph, it will expand to cover the entire display. I can select any area of the graph by dragging a rectangle, and that will magnify that portion that I want to examine. I can always revert back to the original graph. I can double click on the graph again and it will return me back to my display. On the trend, I can maximize it again. I can click on the trend cursor and drag this cursor, and on the upper right corner I can see the values and the times for each one of these points or this line that I'm trending. I can click on the trend axis and change the scale to some absolute number, let's say 0 and 200, and I don't have to be in build mode to edit this y-axis. I hope you enjoy this lab, and happy learning.